is like numericals based on DNA. Now when we talk about DNA, this is a simple diagram which I have made for DNA. This, let us take it as major groove. So we all know that major groove is somewhere around 22 Armstrong. This small one what we see is called as minor groove. So what we need to understand, there is major groove and a minor groove. Minor groove is of 12 Armstrong. So if I take this as the distance between the two minor groove. So understand, the distance between the two minor groove, I call it as pitch of DNA. So distance between the two minor groove is called as pitch of DNA. So basically this is one DNA now. Pitch of DNA is one DNA. So here we need to understand, when I talk about pitch of DNA, so this pitch of DNA is 34 Armstrong in length, and in one pitch of DNA there are 10 nitrogen base pair present. I say 10 nitrogen base pairs present. So 10 nitrogen base pair can also be called as 20 nitrogen base. So in exam, read your question very properly, whether it is saying nitrogen base pair or nitrogen base. Now when we talk about this, this is a turn of the DNA. So we need to understand, one turn of DNA is of 360 degree, and in one turn there are total 10 nitrogen base pair. So in one turn there are 10 nitrogen base pair. So what we can say here, angle turn for each nitrogen base will be 36 degree. Now pitch of DNA is 34 Armstrong, one pitch of DNA 10 nitrogen base pair. So here what we can say, distance between two nitrogen base pair will be 3.4 Armstrong, 34 divided by 10. Now when we go with respect to the next part, that is the diameter of DNA. So we all know that the diameter of DNA is 20 Armstrong. What is 1 Armstrong? So we need to understand, 1 Armstrong is 10 raised to minus 10 meter. Most important thing. This Armstrong can also be converted into nanometer. So we can say 1 nanometer is 10 raised to minus 9 meter. So there are two things. When we go for nitrogen base, there are two nitrogen bases, major group. One you call it as purine and other one you call it as pyrimidine. So purine are double ring, we need to understand this, and pyrimidines, they all are single ring. What is purine? So we have adenine and we have guanine. What is pyrimidine? It is cytosine and thymine. So what we need to understand, most important thing, that the purine and pyrimidine ratio will be always 1:1. It simply means A is going to pair with T with double hydrogen bond, and C is going to pair with G with triple hydrogen bond. The most important concept is here. So this is basic about DNA, how the question comes. So let's try to understand one question. So for one question, we need to understand, let's take that DNA has, let's take 15% of adenine. Now 15% of adenine, find percentage of guanine. Now it's simple. A DNA is having 15% of adenine. So what we need to understand here, see, very simple. 15% of adenine means there is 15% A. Now 15% of A, we need to find out what will be the percentage of G that is guanine. So it's very simple to understand. If A is 15%, T also will be 15% because A is equivalent to T. So 15 and 15, 30% is gone. How much is left is 70%. So out of 70%, you can say 35% will be C and 35% will be G. So what we need to understand, that guanine is 35%. So this is one of the simplest sum that can be asked in exam. There are 500 nitrogen base pair. So 500 nitrogen base pair is already given to you. You need to find the length of DNA. You need to find how much is adenine, how much is guanine, how much is cytosine, how much is thymine. Plus you need to find hydrogen bonds. Name the hydrogen bonds, number of the hydrogen bonds basically present. So what we need to understand here, one pitch is equivalent to one length of DNA. Now in one pitch total there are 10 nitrogen base pair. So how many base pairs we have been given? 500 base pair. So we can say 500 divided by 10, that comes to 50. So 50 length is there. Now one length of DNA corresponds to 34 Armstrong. So 50 multiplied by 34 Armstrong will give you the actual length of the DNA, that comes to somewhere around 1700 Armstrong. So this is the length of the DNA. So this is how you can calculate the length. Now we need to find out A, we need to find out T, we need to find out G, and we need to find out C. So what we need to understand, there are 500 nitrogen base pair. Base pair means this side one strand will be having 500, another strand will be also 500. So adenine is equivalent to thymine, guanine is equal to cytosine. So what we are going to do, we are going to divide it equally. So adenine becomes 250, guanine becomes 250, thymine 250, cytosine 250. So like this you get your the adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. The next question says, this is done, this is done. Next question is hydrogen bond. So between A and T there is double hydrogen bond. Between C and G there is triple hydrogen bond. So basically A and T is 250. So 250 multiplied by 2 will give you 500. C and G, they are triple bond. So it will be 250 multiplied by 3, that is equal to 750. So 500 plus 750 gives you 1250 hydrogen bonds. So like this you can easily calculate the number of hydrogen bonds. So these are the sums that can come. One of the numericals that is asked, it can be, let us take, there are 5 turns of DNA. If there are 5 turns of DNA, we need to find out, let's take again, number of hydrogen bond. We need to find out how much is A, C, T, G. Then we need to find out how many nitrogen base will be present. Now we need to understand, I am talking about base, not base pair. Let's find out the phosphodiester bonds also. So when we talk about phosphodiester bond, I hope you all know, it is a bond between the sugar and the phosphate. So if I make this as the sugar, so there is a bond here between the third carbon and the fifth carbon. This is the phosphate. So this is carbon number 3 and this is carbon number 5. Between them there is a bond. So this bond we basically call it as phosphodiester bond. So how to solve this numericals? So first understand. The question says 5 turns. 5 turns, it simply means in one turn there is 10 nitrogen base pair. So 5 turns, so definitely it will be nothing but 5 into 10, so that is equivalent to 50 nitrogen base pair present. So we have 50 nitrogen base pair. 50 nitrogen base pair is equivalent to 100 nitrogen bases. So one question we have solved, that is the 100 nitrogen base. Now question is ACTNG is how much? So again we write that same funda, A pairs with T and C pairs with G. So between A and T there will be double hydrogen bond. Between C and G there is triple hydrogen bond. There are total 100 nitrogen bases. 100 nitrogen bases means 50 here and 50 here. This 50 we can bifurcate as 25A, 25T, 25C and 25G. So what we came to know, that between A and T total there are 25 multiplied by 2, that is equivalent to 50 hydrogen bond. Between C and G there is a triple bond, so we can say 25 multiplied by 3, that is equal to 75 hydrogen bonds. Now total when it comes to, it is 125. So we have solved the number of hydrogen bonds, that is 125. Number of ATCG is 25, 25 and 25. Phosphodiester bond, we need to understand, total there are 50 here. So 50 means this sugar has to be 50. Right? Sugar, since sugar has to be 50, so the first sugar will not be having any bond here. It will be free phosphate. And last one will be having free OH bond. So what you need to understand here is that if phosphodiester bond will be 50 minus 1, that is equal to 49. So 49 on one side and 49 on other side. So total comes to 98 phosphodiester bond. So like this you can solve the numericals of the DNA.
Hope you liked my video. Do subscribe, share and comment.